A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 20th November, on the front page you have Hyderabad techie MP farmer held in Pakistan for illegal entry. So this is a software engineer from Hyderabad, Telangana, and a farmer from Madhya Pradesh. They were arrested by Pakistani police for illegally entering into the country. The software engineer from Hyderabad, Prashant Madam, he actually is said to be aiming to go to Turkey to meet his girlfriend. And this is a farmer, you can see, Durmilal, a farmer from Madhya Pradesh. So he was also arrested. Then this is Network for Intelligence Agencies to Share Info will go live next year. So the ambitious NATGRID, that is National Intelligence Grid Project, it is said will be operational by December 31, 2020. So this is what the government informed the Lok Sabha. So more than half the sanctioned positions are vacant presently. So you can see NATGRID will help organizations to access database from a common platform. So it will be a network of intelligence agencies. So it will enable multiple security and intelligence agencies to access a database related to immigration entry and exit, banking and telephone details, etc. So there will be a common platform for that. So this NATGRID project was actually started in 2009 with a budget of 2,800 crore rupees. So it's an online database, collating scattered pieces of information and putting them together on one platform. At least 10 central government agencies such as Intelligence Bureau, RAW, Research and Analysis Wing and others will have access to this data on a secured platform. Then below you have Nithyanand faces charges of illegally confining two students. So this is controversial godman Nithyanand. He has been alleged with charges of illegally confining two daughters of a Bengaluru-based couple. So petition has been filed in Gujarat High Court by the couple. So they are seeking help to get back the girls from the ashram set up by Nithyanand. So Nithyanand already faces rape charges. Then below you have trade body pegs Kashmir economic losses at over $1 billion. So this is Kashmir, Kashmir body, Kashmir Commission of Commerce and Industry. So it plans to sue the government for damages too. And this is regarding the new president of Sri Lanka, Gotabaya. He is expected to visit Delhi on November 29th. So this is what the finance minister, Mr. S. Jaishankar, has said, that Prime Minister Modi's invitation has been accepted by the new president of Sri Lanka and he would visit New Delhi. Then on page 7 you have prolonged rains help tackle drought. So this is regarding the state of Maharashtra. Here a state authority had conducted a survey on number of villages facing drought conditions in 2020. So when 2018 survey was conducted for drought conditions in 2019, it had said that 11,487 villages would face water scarcity due to rainfall deficit. But this survey of 2019-20 now shows that water scarcity would be there in 389 villages in 14 tests. So this is a significant reduction which has been done, happened because of prolonged rains. So 28% area of Maharashtra is highly dissected plateau, which includes the Konkan, Western Ghats and other hilly areas. And 44% is moderately dissected plateau with medium water seepage capacity. And rest is undissected plateau, so where groundwater availability is higher. Also, it is said that Maharashtra has higher drought situation too, because 82% of Maharashtra consists of basaltic rock, which has the capacity to store merely 1 to 3% water. Metamorphic rocks cover 10% of the region, which too do not hold much water, and remaining 8% of these, 5.5 is sedimentary rock while rest is alluvial. So where storage, water storage will be good from 5 to 10%. On page 8 you have clear look at solar eclipse in Cheruvathur. So this is Kasargod district of Kerala. So here it will have, this region will have the first view of December 26 phenomena of solar eclipse. You can see people of Kasargod district will have this rare opportunity to witness the December 26 solar eclipse, first in all of India. So Cheruvathur here is one of the three places in the world where the eclipse will be most clearly seen. So this is detailing out about solar eclipse. You should know about how solar eclipse occurs. Solar eclipse when the sun is covered. Sun is covered actually by the moon. When moon comes in between the earth and the sun, and the alignment is such that it may result in darkness, you know, total eclipse also in this much region of the earth, and partial eclipse in the other regions around it. On page 9, you have 53 road crashes, 17 deaths per hour in 2018. So it is said overspeeding is a major killer, followed by driving on the wrong side. So this is what the annual government report says, that more than 1.5 lakh people lost their lives in road crashes in the country in 2018. And this is an increase of 2.4% as compared to a year before. So this is a cause of concern. So here the details also given. You can see overspeeding led to majority of deaths. Then no helmets, no seat belts, driving on wrong side. So here you can see the red line is for percentage change in deaths, and this is percentage change in instances. So here you can see driving on wrong side has increased significantly. Then below you have Supreme Court recommends permanent commission for women in army. So Supreme Court has asked the armed forces to consider granting permanent commission to women officers under short service commission who have joined before 2019, March 2019. So the army actually had notified permanent commission to women officers, but then that was for those who joined forces under short service commission, SSC, after March 2019. So court is asking for considering even for those who have joined before March 2019. It's asking armed forces to consider this. The government has already notified permanent jobs for women officers in 10 branches of army, but that is for after March 2019. On the editorial page, the first editorial is House Not in Order. So this is talking about the parliament as such. It says no parliament can condone the preventive detention of its members for long periods. So this is in the context of Lok Sabha member Farooq Abdullah being detained in Jammu and Kashmir. And second editorial, Iran on the boil. So Iran presently we have seen how it raised petrol prices and it resulted in protests in the country. So Iran is struggling under the weight of US sanctions and it needs to revive the nuclear deal. The lead article as such is a harbinger of the new hardline normal, hard right normal. So this talks of US President Donald Trump. So it says Trump is the logical end product of an old, grand old party strategy of appealing to the white community's worst instincts. So he's a right-wing politician. So this is hard right as such. So, politics in USA is discussed here. And this is turning the policy focus to child undernutrition. So it says India has sustained its progress in reducing stunting and number of underweight children in the last decade. But now policy focus should be on child undernutrition. The comprehensive national nutrition survey report, which has been released recently, assumed salience because two important factors which are there, hunger and malnutrition. So they have India's performance in reducing undernutrition as such has been mixed, but there has been a moderate decline in stunting but not in wasting. So focused approach here is required now. Then on the op-ed page, you have the threat to the idea of a public university. So this is regarding protests in JNU, Jawaharlal Nehru University. So it says education is a right, not a privilege reserved for the select elite. So when a free hike takes place, students have been protesting here and they have not been happy with the partial rollback. They want complete rollback of these price hikes. And here you have rebalancing counterterrorism. So this says as Israel shows an effective strategy must be comprehensive. So it says how should India respond to next terrorist attack sponsored by Pakistan? So future attacks are inevitable, it says. So what should be done? So in that context, the way Israel's military response is considered as an effective counterterrorism strategy. So Israel itself has shown counterterrorism requires a balance, including at least three other lines of efforts apart from punishment. So it requires effective denial operations to make terrorist attacks more difficult for the enemy. So second, it requires shaping operations to incentivize the adversary to limit its attacks. So Israel uses carrot and stick approach. So it brings economic development programs as such and then harsher security restrictions too. And third, it requires cultivating resilience to reduce the political impact of terrorism. On page 12, you have stone throwing on the decline. So this is what Home Ministry said, that such incidents in Jammu and Kashmir have reduced after August 5. So when there are such restrictions and lockdown in the state or presently the Union Territory, of course, it has affected economy significantly. So stone throwing has also declined. Then this is, we are becoming a police state. So this is what the counsel, senior advocate Dushyant Dave has said in the Supreme Court, that we are slowly becoming a police state. So he was referring to the blanket restrictions placed in Jammu and Kashmir after its special status under Article 370 of the Constitution was revoked on August 5. So he said that government has brought draconian and sweeping restrictions on all persons in the state without knowing whether they had a criminal history or not. So such blanket restrictions violate right to life and liberty under Article 21. It asks the court to stand up for the people. On page 13, you have anti-lynching bills being examined, says Centre. So anti-lynching bills passed by Rajasthan and Manipur assemblies were being examined by the central government. They are yet to get president's consent. So this is what the Lok Sabha was informed by the government. So two states, you can see, Rajasthan and Manipur have passed these anti-lynching bills, but they have not yet got president's assent to make them effective. So then this is electoral bonds. CEC objected to 1% vote share norm. So this is regarding the electoral bonds on which the Central Information Commission had objected. So Finance Ministry had brushed aside objections, including those of Law Ministry. So these are documents obtained by RTA application which show these details. So 1% vote norm share, vote share in the Lok Sabha and State Assembly elections is required to be eligible for the electoral bond scheme for any political party. On international page, you have Israel settlements not illegal, says US. So the decision as such taken by USA will provide greater space for Israelis and Palestinians to negotiate peace. So this is what has been stated by US Secretary of State Mike Pompeo. So this is said to be the latest political gift from Trump administration to Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu. So US calls Israeli settlements to be not illegal. Then this is regarding riots in Iran, in Hong Kong. That is old news continuing. This is regarding Julian Assange. So rape investigation has been dropped against him by a Swedish prosecutor. It is said evidence is not strong enough to file an indictment. So you should know about Julian Assange. He is WikiLeaks founder. And in 2010, rape allegation had been filed against him, but then the credibility of plaintiff's claim has been questioned, and that is why the investigation has been dropped. So he's wanted in USA actually, and he's presently in British prison since April 2019, police dragged him out of the Ecuadorian embassy in London, where he had been holed up since 2012 to avoid an extradition order to Sweden. But now Sweden was also, through which he would be sent to USA because of WikiLeaks. Government documents had been leaked and details had been brought out in public in media houses across the world regarding US government policies. So he's wanted in USA. Sweden had these cases so that extradition could take place there. And he was in Ecuadorian embassy in London in Britain. But in 2019 April, British arrested him from the embassy. On business page, you have telcos asked to share infrastructure. So Department of Telecom Advisory, which aims to boost connectivity in public places, has asked telecom companies to share infrastructure. So all telecom service providers are advised to share the in-building infrastructure, with other telecom service providers in all existing government places and buildings like railways, metros, etc., hospitals. So that is it. These are the important headlines. The last page does not have news coverage. There is sports coverage on the last page. So these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website aasha.com. Thank you.